Welcome back to Right Specs. Please remember to subscribe. Today comparison, we have played the Samsung A53 versus the Realme GT Neo 3. Now let's get into it. The A53 is coming with a Super AMOLED display, which is a lot better than the standard AMOLED display in the GT Neo 3. Both devices come in with a 120Hz refresh rate, which is pretty decent to have. Pixel density, we find that the A53 is a little bit better at 407 when compared to 395 in the GT Neo 3. Resolution, both devices will be a fully HD plus, remember. Screen size, you find that the GT Neo is coming with a 6.7 inch display, which is a little bit bigger than the 6.5 in the A53. Aspect ratio, both are coming with a standard 20:9 aspect ratio. Water resistant, Samsung is doing pretty well with the IP67 in all their latest devices. Protection, both devices coming with a Gorilla Glass version 5. And for that, we're gonna give the Samsung A53 a better screen. Now let's get into the hardware. At 2.85Hz, you find that the GT is a little bit better than the 2.4Hz in the Samsung A53. The chipset, the Dimensity, is a bit better than the Exynos 1280 chipset. Same goes for the GPU, you'll find that the GT Neo is a little bit better. Both devices out of the box will come in the Android 12, which both devices support a 5G network. Battery, you'll find that both devices come with a 5000 mAh battery, but the power will vary due to the screen and chipset. Within 32 minutes, you'll receive a full charge in the GT Neo, and within 1 hour plus, you'll get a full charge in the Samsung A53. But that will give the GT Neo a better performance. Now for the camera. A53 is coming with a 64 megapixel camera, which is a bit better than the 50 megapixel in the GT Neo. Ultra wide is also a bit better in the Samsung A53 with 12 megapixel, same for the macro lens. So for that, we give the rear camera to the A53. Both devices support 4K videoing, but the GT Neo, you'll get up to 60 frames per second. Selfie camera, the A53 is a bit better with 32 megapixel. Same, they will perform the same in low light. Same goes for the video. The Samsung A53 is better, so for that we give the Samsung A53 a better camera. Now for the storage. No memory card is supported in the GT Neo, but for the Samsung, you can use up to 1TB memory card. UFS, you get up to 3.1 in the GT Neo. As for the Samsung A53, I think it should be 2.1. For the RAM, you get up to a 12GB RAM in the GT Neo, while it's 8GB in the Samsung A53. Both devices will come with up to 256GB of RAM, but due to the UFS, we'll give the better storage to the GT Neo 3. Now for the design. Ooh, the A53 is a bit smaller than the GT Neo. Same for width, just a tiny bit smaller, the A53. Thickness, both devices are 8mm thickness. And for the gram, just 1g lesser, the GT Neo over the A53. Other features are like the Type-C port. No headphone jack in neither of the device, but you can always use your headphone, the Type-C version. As for radio, they're both not supported. NFC, both device supported, even though some people are not sure what NFC is or what it's for. The fingerprint in display with both device. And Bluetooth 5.3. Pretty fast. Now for the result. For $499, you can get the Samsung A53, and for $399, you'll be able to purchase the GT Neo. For the Samsung A53, has a better screen, better camera, better design, while we'll give the winning to the GT Neo 3 for a better hardware, better storage. So comment below which one you prefer, and see you in the next one, guys. Bye.